Someone once said, even God couldn't sink the Titanic. That was one of the many claims made in 1912 when the impressive ship was launched. That boastful attitude ultimately created complacency amongst the crew of the ship, which tragically led to catastrophe.
On the Titanic's maiden voyage, the captain ignored repeated warnings regarding ice fields in Titanic's path of travel. Yet, with these warnings being known to the captain, he ignored them and went to bed, with no orders to the crew to be on the alert for icebergs.
Why do you have two steering wheels?
We really only use this near shore.
Excuse me, sir. Another ice warning. This one's from the Norden.
Thank you, Spot. Oh, not to worry. Quite normal for this time of year. In fact, we're speeding up. I've just ordered the last boilers lit.
Yes. I don't think I've ever seen such a flat calm.
Like a mill pond. Not a breath of wind.
It will make the bergs harder to see, with no breaking water at the base.
Well, I'm off. Maintain speed on heading, Mr. Lighthall.
Yes, sir.
Shortly thereafter, the unsinkable ship struck an iceberg. A mere 160 minutes later, it had disappeared below the waters and was descending towards the ocean floor, 2.5 miles below. So much for God-defying arrogance. It is easy to ignore warnings. Millions, even billions of people are doing just that today. They too are ignoring the icebergs. What haunts me the most, when I see video footage of the Titanic wreckage, is the emotion it invokes in me. America is in a similar condition today, because people are not heeding God's warning message of the coming disaster. Our country is headed for a catastrophe that will make the Titanic tragedy pale in comparison. On June 18, 2023, a submersible called the Titan descended into the North Atlantic Ocean to visit the Titanic wreckage. Stockton Rush, CEO of Titan manufacturer OceanGate, was one of 5 men on board the vessel. To the chagrin of many, he had repeatedly ignored many warnings from deep submersibles experts during the construction of the Titan. Rush said he did not want to build a vessel using ex-military submarine men. 50-year-old white guys, he mockingly called them. He wanted his team to be younger, to be inspirational, and to have a variety of different backgrounds. He and his staff had dismissed several industry experts' concerns over safety during construction of the Titan vessel. Rush eagerly sought a reputation as an innovator and felt excessive safety protocols and regulations hindered that goal. Somebody said, "You are remembered for the rules that you break." And that is a fact, he said in a 60 Minutes television interview. There are a lot of rules out there that do not make engineering sense to me. Therefore, I think I can do this just as safely by breaking those rules. However, apparently unknown to Mr. Rush, physical laws are unyielding. They do not care how inspirational or diverse your engineering team is. And later, when the Titan was under 2.5 miles of ocean water, its hull being squeezed by nearly a ton and a half of pressure per square inch, disaster struck. 1 hour and 45 minutes into Titan's dive, the United States Navy, while monitoring the situation, heard an unusual underwater sound. That unusual sound was Titan's hull imploding at a speed of 2,200 feet per second. One expert said the Titan implosion would be like crushing a 50-gallon drum to the size of a very small marble. Sadly, America is like the Titan. It has ignored warnings. It is punctured and is sinking fast. It is like the similarly doomed Titan because Americans are prioritizing inspiration, diversity, and other trendy virtues, and breaking God's rules simply because they do not make sense to them. This mindset is driving all sorts of radical innovation. In many parts of America, there are extreme efforts taking place to defund police forces, as well as the rethinking of law enforcement in general. There are people in high places who purport replacing meat from animals with insect protein and with lab-engineered foods. They desperately want to erase America's national borders in the name of ethnic and cultural diversity, while they pretend that biological sex and gender are utterly unrelated to one another. Thousands of years of human tradition, experience, and wisdom are now routinely cast aside without hesitation of any kind. The main trouble in so many of these areas is that what is actually being cast aside is not prejudice, or parochialism, or stodginess, but the immutable, inescapable laws of God. Laws, given by the one lawgiver, reference James, chapter 4, verse 12, cannot be broken without suffering the consequences of doing so. Innovation wrought by breaking those laws is illusory. Just look around, the more people cast aside God's laws governing morality, sex, family, health, commerce, leadership, government, and religion, the more lives we see imploding, communities imploding, and nations imploding. What is happening today is a highly pressurized, rapidly compacting version of what human beings have been proving for over 6,000 years. The entire world has always suffered from criminality, poverty, conflict, corruption, disease, and malevolence because the very first humans deliberately chose to break the rules governing human existence. They followed Satan's advice. They did not listen to God, as doing that would only hinder innovation. Because of human disobedience, God has allowed mankind to innovate and build a multifaceted civilization under the sway of Satan's deceptions. Tragically, the world is showing the turbulent results of those acts. Education, knowledge, religion, government, culture, music, entertainment, sports, technology, and people's general attitude about life are all deeply influenced by that evil being who seeks to destroy all of humanity, just as he destroyed our first parents. Reference 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 4 and Revelation, chapter 12, verse 9. Revelation, chapter 18, is a prophecy about Babylon. Babylon may be the best single word in the Bible that describes the current world system, a system which is cut off from God. The entire world has gotten mixed up in that system. This prophecy, as presented in Revelation, reveals this mixed-up world's ultimate end. The world will sink just as the Titanic did, and implode just as the Titan did. By recognizing the world situation as it really is, one can easily see that the path to humankind's oblivion is growing clearer by the day. God commands us, "Come out of her, my people, so that you will not participate in her sins, and receive any of her plagues." Reference Revelation, chapter 18, verse 4. You must reject Satan and his satanic rule-breaking. You must come out and humble yourself. Heed the warnings and follow God, the lawgiver. And even as the pressure mounts, in a world rapidly descending underwater, you shall remain safe.